When that liquor get up in me. When that liquor get up in me. When that liquor get up in me. When that liquor get up in me.
I'm a motherfucking beast.
When that liquor get up in me.
Tell these niggas clear the street.
When that liquor get up in me.
I be all up in my zone.
When that liquor get up in me.
I ain't never going home.
Hello and welcome to the Online Strength Coach Podcast, episode 78. What is general preparation? How's it going? Welcome to episode 78 of the Online Strength Coach Podcast. Today's topic doesn't come from a user's question. It's mainly come off the back of a couple of things that happened last week. Mainly, I read an article last week pertaining to strength and conditioning training for sport, and how what most of the methodologies that we use within strength and conditioning training are general physical preparation. They don't really enter into like a what you'll see with Bondichuk and his special preparation, which pertains almost exclusively to throwers. Or what I'll relate this to is for powerlifters and weightlifters, but mainly powerlifters, as that tends to be what the majority of general weight trainers use in their own programs. So the second thing that spurred this on as well was I was at the Boris Shilko UK Tour London seminar yesterday, which was excellent. Highly recommend if you ever get the chance to, not that I should really be need to upsell this, but if you ever get the chance to be at a Shilko seminar and you're involved with strength training or powerlifting at any level, would highly recommend that you go along and check it out. And there's a lot of things to learn from that man. He gave a 3-hour lecture. It was meant to be a 2-hour talk. It ended up being 2 hours 40, 3 hours with audience questions thrown in. And in that time, people were asking questions. And one of the questions was, what do you think are the best general preparation or GPP, as you'll know if you read Westside or T-Nation or you've been reading articles for a while, you'll have heard of GPP in these kind of articles, or general physical preparation. But he asked, for powerlifters or for Shilko's lifters, this guy asked, what does he think are the best general physical preparation exercises? What do you think works best for powerlifting? And then he went on to mention things like tire flips, log lifts, farmer's walks. And then Shilko replied basically that these exercises mean nothing for powerlifting. And then he went on to say Lou Simmons is a great trainer and like retract and whatever, but guess what people, I think people struggle with this topic quite a lot because they don't really understand where it comes from or how it relates to them as a general trainer or as a general strength trainer. So we look at a use case of an athlete. So let's look within the term of a rugby player, because it's quite easy. So what I work with day in, day out, it's very easy for me to apply it to them. So general physical preparation for a rugby player is basic strength training, basic cardiovascular fitness training, and basic speed training, basic plyometrics, kind of lower level basics that they need to get in. They need to train to a reasonable level to allow them to engage with the more specific or the more important aspects of their training. So for instance, if a number 10 or a scrum half, if their general physical preparation isn't adequate, as in, for instance, their VO2 max or their aerobic fitness is not sufficient to allow them to play at match speed or just to keep up with the game, then they won't be able to do their job as a scrum half or a 10. So a scrum half needs to go from breakdown to breakdown, needs to get there fast. They cover the number 9 and the number 15 typically cover the most ground in a game. So they need a good base of aerobic fitness. if a nine, so for example, if a famous rugby player who doesn't have such good aerobic conditioning, such as Bastardo, if Bastardo was to play nine, he would be reasonably ineffective. And that's not to say that his pass isn't good enough, or you know, that he's not quick enough to make the breakdowns. You know, he's 120 odd kilos. His aerobic conditioning is not going to be the same as a Ben Youngs or a Greg Laidlaw, guys who are, you know, 5'10 to 6 foot and, you know, 80 to 90 kilos. And lean with that, guys who are aerobically well suited, smaller people are generally better suited to aerobic activities because they haven't got so much muscle mass, they haven't got so much weight to carry around. Less muscle mass means that they don't produce as much waste products when they move. It's typically why a Mo Farah or a Paula Radcliffe, they tend to be 50 to 60 kilos. Because to be a good endurance athlete, being small helps a lot. So that's kind of one of the reasons why when you look at a rugby team, some guys are different shapes and sizes because the role calls for different physical qualities. So for that player, that 9 or that 10 or that 15, who have a large running component to their game, if they don't have that underlying aerobic fitness, they can't function. So they need that general physical preparedness to play that role, to be that position. Now, what's this mean for a lifter? This is where people get confused. So as a lifter, your aerobic base is not necessarily an irrelevance, but it is very peripheral to your actual performance. So for example, a weightlifter who trains with high volumes, having a higher aerobic fitness is a desirable adaptation because that higher level of aerobic fitness means that you recover faster, not only from sets but also from sessions. Having some kind of base underlying fitness, if you train with high frequencies and high volumes, is a desirable thing. It's not an essential thing, but it is something that would be a nice to have. As a heavier lifter, or as a lifter who trains 3 times a week and can train at their leisure, an aerobic base is an irrelevance because you don't require the ability. If it takes you 5 to 7 minutes to recover from a set, then it's not impeding your training volumes. It's not impeding your recovery from session to session because you've got minimum of 48 hours to recover. So it's not impeding your progress within your sport, which is powerlifting or weightlifting or CrossFit or whatever your sport is. If you train with low frequency or basically there isn't a high recovery demand to what you're doing, then that aerobic base is an irrelevance for that sport. So having that GPP isn't really helpful. It doesn't help. So when we relate like GPP for strength, GPP exercise for strength for a rugby player is just being capable at basic barbell lifts. So having a reasonable squat, having a reasonable deadlift, having a reasonable bench, having a reasonable pull-up, having a reasonable clean, reasonable push press, that allows them to better utilize more relevant training methods such as plyometrics, speed, agility training, or unit-specific strength exercises such as scrumming, power and contact, breaking tackles. These are special preparation exercises, are special preparation or sport-specific preparation that will have a direct impact on their sport performance. The general strength just allows them to better utilize or to be better at those specific modalities. Now, as a powerlifter or as a general strength trainer, as a powerlifter, relate this to squat, bench press, and deadlift as performed in competition. That is your special preparation. That is your primary fitness goal, is to become better at those three lifts. Now, when we look at a general preparation for that task, what is a general strength? What general strength tasks can let you better utilize back squat, deadlift, and bench press? back squat, bench press, and deadlift variations that have some kind of carryover into your competition lift. So, as a powerlifter, if you squat in a suit, if you're an equipped lifter, then a good general preparation exercise would be a raw squat. That's a great, like a raw squat with maybe wraps only, is an excellent general physical preparation exercise for that use case. As an equipped bench presser, it's the same scenario. As an equipped bench presser, raw bench press is a good general physical preparation exercise for that lift. And again, for deadlift, this is the exact same rationale. Now, when we look at raw lifters, or what the majority of people who listen to this, or what the majority of people are nowadays, they're general strength trainees, or they compete in powerlifting, but they compete in raw or classic powerlifting. So what's a good general preparation exercise for these lifts? For back squat, good general preparation would be front squat, pause squat, box squat, chain squat, basically anything that any squat variation that takes you through the same or greater range of motion that you utilize in your sport, or maybe something that overloads certain parts of the lift. These are good preparatory or general exercises. Same with bench press, maybe incline, shoulder, decline, close grip, variations that utilize the same muscle groups in a similar plane of motion is good general physical preparation for that exercise. And deadlift likewise, block pulls, rack pulls, trap bar to a lesser extent, deficit pulls, top down pulls, RDLs, it's good general physical preparation for those tasks. Doing things like circuit training or pushing prowlers or doing logs or tires or stones or whatever, these aren't general physical preparation for the three main barbell lifts. It's just, they're just awkward lifts. They maybe could be utilized as a fitness training modality where you want to maybe get a little bit fitter, so you maybe you're moving down a weight class, or maybe you just want to have that aerobic capacity to recover quicker from sets or recover quicker from sessions. But that aerobic training would probably be better suited for most lifters coming from just a general cardiovascular activity such as swimming, biking, running for lighter lifters. These things aren't going to stress muscles, or they're not going to stress the neural system, or they basically will have zero impact when done at sufficiently low intensity. They will have zero impact on your strength training, which is what you're here for at the end of the day if you're a powerlifter or you're a general strength trainee. Doing circuit training and stuff like that as a lifter is non-specific volume. It is non-helpful volume, really. It can be fun for people. I mean, if you do it as a hobby and you want to do a strongman circuit, or you want to do some strongman training, or you want to go into strongman, then obviously there's nothing to stop you from doing that, and that's sweet. But it's not general physical preparation for lifting. It's just completely non-related. So I hope that you have a bit more of an understanding of where general physical preparation might lie within certain use cases, why it's more relevant to more general athletes. So a more general athlete is a games player, a rugby player is probably the most general athlete you can come across, or American football player, basketball player, netball player, athletes who utilize a large variety of systems. They need speed, they need power, they need strength, they need cardiovascular fitness, they need anaerobic fitness, they need repeatability, they need many different things. For this athlete, general physical preparation is a key thing for them, and it lets them achieve greater levels of specific fitness. But as a lifter, general preparation can help you reach higher levels of fitness, which for a lifter is strength, but it needs to be targeted, it needs to be related to what you're doing. So for a weightlifter, getting better at their log is not general physical preparation. it is separate physical preparation. They're doing strongman training when they need to be focused towards, if they want to be a weightlifter, they need to be focused towards getting better at snatch and clean and jerk if they want to be a better weightlifter. Okay, that concludes this episode. Hope you find it useful. Any comments, questions, please leave them below. If you'd like to get in touch for whatever reason, my email is speedpowerperformance@gmail.com. Thank you very much for listening, and I'll catch you in the next episode. Cheers.
Till I fall, get money till I die. These haters want my paper and them snakes is out to give it. So when I leave this bitch, I'm taking everything with me.